afternoon, everyone. This is Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show, and today is Thursday, and today we have a special episode for you. Today, we interviewed Annie Somerville from Green's Restaurant in San Francisco. We want to bring that to you. We are in Omaha right now, and I do want to say this, guys. When we were skiing in Utah, I got sunburned. I know I talk about the best protection from sun is in the shade, but in this case, we were out skiing, and I got sunburned, and my lip seriously got sunburned, so it's real chapped and real kind of nasty. I'll tell you what has been really effective in helping it heal. It's been this. Anne-Marie just happened to find this at, where'd you find it?
The Expo West.
At Expo West, and it's called Bella Vado, and it's an avocado stick lip care, and it says peppermint patty in it. So it's got, let's see here, it's got gourmet olive oil, shea butter, beeswax, jojoba oil, rose hip, vitamin E, spearmint, and peppermint essential oils. Really, really, really awesome. You can find this at CaliforniaAvocadoOil.com. CaliforniaAvocadoOil.com. They also make soaps. Annie Somerville is going to be talking about Green's, how an organic restaurant is run, some of her favorite recipes, some of her favorite ingredients. I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. Take care.
Now, what are some of the challenges of staying organic and staying, you know, in this type of local farm food type business? I mean, it must be a challenging time.
Well, it's challenging. I would say it's more rewarding than challenging.
Okay.
Because, you know, it's what keeps Greens vigorous. It's the thing that keeps us going. And it's what makes it exciting for people to work here, because we're really doing it. So that when they talk to our customers, it's not a made up story. It's the real thing, and it's the thing we've been doing for all these years. So that's great. And then I think the challenges are in terms of ordering, like that's from an operations end.
Yeah.
Sometimes our walk-in has, sometimes our walk-in is very full because of just the, we are ordering as to when our farmers can deliver.
Right.
So it's a little different than calling a produce purveyor and just saying, you know, I'd like X amount for today and then plan on getting X amount tomorrow.
Right.
So there's a whole art to how you order and how you make sure that you're that using everything.
And changing the menu, too.
It's really fresh. Changing the menu. And then also balancing, like in the winter months, early spring, it can be, everybody's got lots of chard and kale and beets and bitter greens. So how do you spread that out? How do we spread out our orders amongst all the different growers we like to support?
Right.
So there's that too.
Okay. Nice.
And then in terms of the menu, that's probably the most fun thing because our menus are about what's in season. And, you know, just basically what I see at the farmer's market, what we talk to growers about, and, you know, it's just like what's good, what's really good. And one of the other really great rewards for me of shopping at the farmer's market is not only do I get to visualize and taste all of this incredible produce, which is produce that is not available in the greater marketplace,
mm-hmm.
I get to meet the growers, I get to talk to them, I get to meet, there's a whole subculture at the market, which is really great, friends and family who come to work with the farmers.
Mm-hmm.
And I also get to meet all these chefs, people who are very committed to doing this. And they're chefs who are cooking, oftentimes, you know, they wouldn't necessarily be restaurants that I would go to. But it's just great meeting them because they're wonderful people. And, you know, we're all very committed to what we're doing. And then I also get to meet and talk with the people who are committed to shopping at the farmer's market.
Right.
And then many home cooks who are fantastic cooks who give me great ideas. So, you know, we share recipes and share ideas. And, you know, I just ask people, what are you going to do with that? You know, because it's wonderful.
So that's where you learn some of your
definitely
stuff? Okay.
Definitely.
Oh, cool.
Definitely.
So what are some of your favorite ingredients?
Oh, boy. That's a tough one. Let's see. Right now, what's my favorite? Because we're just, you know, it's early spring.
Mm-hmm.
So we've had strawberries for a few weeks. Ooh. So that's very exciting when strawberries appear. We've had asparagus for about a month. That's very exciting. The bitter greens, all the different family members of the radicchios and chicories are kind of giving way now because the weather's warming up. And so we are, you know, all the tender greens are starting to come in, like pea tendrils, fava shoots, fava leaves, all the beautiful lettuces, the mosh, you know, just all the leafy greens that do well in warmer weather are coming on. So
right.
That's really great.
What are some of your favorite, maybe one or two of your favorite recipes?
Oh boy. Okay, that totally depends. I love anything that uses greens. Okay. So chard, kale. So, you know, anytime we can, for instance, this doesn't sound particularly springy, but, you know, if we can make an Italian butter bean soup, okay, and then finish that with, like, thinly sliced leaves of like, a lacinato kale or rainbow chard. I love sautéed greens, so chard, kale, all the different members of the kale family. And that, again, is one of the rewards of shopping the farmer's market and working with small growers, is these different varieties that appear that are just fun to use and really delicious. Our wilted spinach salad is always a great one because we get to feature usually a savoy leaf spinach grown, okay, by one of our growers, and then having anything in it from the bitter greens to dandelion, frise, you name it, yeah, red orac, and then we can put different cheeses, different like roasted peppers, apples, pears, any combination of ingredients in there.
What is orac?
Red orac is a beautiful, it's an old world green, and it's in the Chenopodia family. Okay. So it's in the, I believe it's in the spinach family. It's kind of, it tends to like to grow, it's a little salty tasting.
Okay.
Tends to, I think, like to grow in areas where there's like a little bit of the, there's a little saltiness in the soil. So it's really pretty and delicious.
It's interesting that you say that there are some people who are shopping at these places, chefs who are shopping, who you wouldn't go to their restaurants. I think that's good news, right?
Well, no, and when I say that, I mean,
I know
it's mainly because, I mean, these are great chefs and they have fantastic restaurants. It's just that because I'm a vegetarian,
yeah,
I wouldn't necessarily be dining in those establishments.
Right.
However, I've come to find that they're, you know, these are just wonderful people. And also, even if I did dine in the restaurant, I wouldn't necessarily get to know them in that informal way that we all get to meet each other, right, at the farmer's market.
How is Zen food prep? Is it different than, and say, you know, prep it with, like, the local pizza shop or something like that?
Well, let's see. Yes. Probably.
Yeah.
At Zen Center, in the three Zen Center kitchens, there's a very much of a focus on mindfulness in the kitchen. So working very quietly, in a very concentrated way. And, you know, the goal is bringing the concentration and the focus of your meditation practice into your everyday activities.
Okay.
And certainly kitchen, and working in the kitchen is a great way to do that. So I would say the Zen Center kitchens tend to probably be a little quieter than the Greens Kitchen. Composting, having your own...
Do you compost here?
Yes.
Really?
Well, let's put it this way. We've got two operations going. First of all, when Green Gulch Farm delivers to us, they pick up buckets of food scraps,
okay,
which go back to Green Gulch for their composting system. So we do that. And then San Francisco has a really great recycling program. We are, you know, doing a phenomenal job because a number of years ago, we simply started running out of landfill space.
Mm-hmm.
So the city was forced to really take recycling head on, and it's been great. So we do our kitchen scraps, cardboard, and paper go into a composting system done by the city, and it ends up actually by our garbage company. And then that ends up being, in the end, the result is organic compost.
Wow.
So, which is used by a lot of small farms and wineries as well.
Great.
So we don't compost on site, but
right,
we basically see that all of our food scraps either go to Green Gulch or are part of the recycling program.
Well, it's amazing that you've come to realization that the conscious business is important. You know?
It is. It is, and it's just, and also it's just the right thing to be doing. And again, it's just part of our philosophy of what's the right thing to do. And there's always more to do, and we always feel like we can improve.
Yeah.
All right, so your question of the day, what's your favorite lip gloss or lip product, or even if you use it in the container, maybe some of you guys use just coconut oil or something like that, but go ahead, post it down below. As I'm using the Bella Veda, I'm sure they're happy about this. Post it down below. It's Kevin Gianni from the Renegade Health Show. Together we can change the health of the world one show at a time.